Do you think it's acceptable to make foam core corners this way? Do you think it's okay to leave cuts in your foam core on the edges like this? For goodness sakes, do you think it's okay to bend foam core without cutting it or scoring it first? Well, then this video is not for you. Foam core, advanced basics, how not to suck at it, and how to make it look like you know what you're doing, tips and tricks. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. In the first video of this series, we took a look at how to make some basic cubes. If you haven't seen that video, go back, watch that before you check out this one. Here's some good basic tools that you'll definitely need for this. A good steel ruler, some very sharp blades, some white glue, a good cutting board, and of course, some foam core. As a designer, let's take a look at how you want to approach making some of your models. Ultimately, you want good craftsmanship and good quality. In this instance, we're going to build a 2-inch tall diameter cylinder. I'm going to score my strip of foam core every 5 millimeters so that I can start to get a little bend in the piece. Let's start on the end caps. I'm going to make some 2-inch diameter end caps. And I'm also going to mark a 1/2-inch diameter smaller circle inside of that because I'm going to end up removing that material with a rabbet cut. We're going to take this end cap here and we're going to do something a little different. We're going to take it over to the belt sander to sand it round because cutting circles without a laser is difficult in foam core. We're going to remove about 1/4-inch material around the edge of the end cap. I'm even going to scrape off the little bit of excess that's attached with the adhesive to the foam. Now back to the vertical part, the big 2-inch strip that we cut slits in before. I'm going to go to every single one of those slits and I'm going to make a little V groove, meaning I'm going to remove a little bit of material, probably about 1 millimeter of material from every single one of those grooves. What that's going to do is I'm going to allow me to bend the foam core in a tight enough radius around the end caps that we just made. So I use a little piece of tape once I get the part to the correct lengths. And I angle the piece because it's round. And I put a little piece of tape and I measure the diameter to make sure that the end cap fits correctly. It's all done by eye. You could measure it. I do use a little bit of hot glue here for the simple reason that the hot glue sets up quite quickly versus Elmer's glue. Again, here, hot glue is pretty good when you're hacking this together as it allows you to contour the sides to the end cap. Another option here would be some 5-minute quick set epoxy. It does cause the hot glue to ooze out a little bit and I have to trim it off. Let's take a look at how we're going to make some softer radiuses and fillets and some beveled edges. So this first one that I'm going to show you, we're going to basically make about a 45 degree V cut and simply bend the foam core to get a nice soft radius. Let's say you wanted to make a beveled edge. I'm going to make 2 V cuts, and in between those 2 V cuts is going to be where our bevel is. So pretty straightforward, just like before, we're going to like soft radius on that bevel as well. If you're in a big hurry and you want to be a really big hack, you can basically just crush the foam core with a tool without doing anything. So I'm going to score this piece of foam right here with just a round dowel. That's going to crush the foam and give me a soft radius. It's not going to be really nice. It's going to be a little bit uneven, but it's super quick. And sometimes that's all the time you have, or you don't even have an X-acto with you and you need some way to bend that foam. If you need to make something a little bit more precision, let's say a softer radius curve, then you can make a series of these V cuts. I'm making 3 of them here, and that's going to give me a really nice soft radius. I take the 2-inch strip with all the different edges and bevels that we have, and I fold it up, and I have an overlapping piece, and that's going to give us some exposed foam, and we don't want that. So we're going to take a piece of white artist tape that very closely matches the finish on the foam core. You could spray paint this too if you needed to. And we're just going to cut the tape to match the edge. And we're not going to have any exposed foam. All right, let's build the end cap for this bad boy. I squeeze in a little bit of hot glue. And as your mom would tell you, of course, that melts the foam. So a better choice here would be white glue, or even faster or quicker would be like a 5-minute epoxy. That would actually be a better choice. I'm going to take a piece of material again that matches the foam, and I'm going to white glue some end caps onto this. And I'm going to put a little weight on here and let that dry overnight or at least a few hours. Then I'm going to come back with a brand new sharp x-acto blade, and I'm going to trim everything off so that it matches the edges, and I'm going to get a really nice end cap. That's some advanced basic edges and foam core techniques. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. That really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.